अस्सलाम वालेकुम रहमतुल्लाहि व बरकातहू। इन अवर प्रीवियस क्लास वी हैव बीन डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द सेक्स डिटर्मिनेशन। सो इन अवर बॉडी वी विल फाइंड द 46 सेट ऑफ क्रोमोसोम्स। दैट क्रोमोसोम्स वी हैव बीन डिवाइडेड इनटू द टू टाइप्स। सो वन इज द ऑटोसोम्स एंड अदर वन इज द ऑलोसोम्स। सो ऑलोसोम्स वी डिटरमाइन द सेक्स ऑफ एन ऑर्गेनिजम्स। सो आवर प्रीवियस क्लास थ्री वी हैव बीन डिस्कस्ड द टाइप्स ऑफ सेक्स सेक्स डिटर्मिनेशन। सो देर आर थ्री टाइप्स ऑफ सेक्स डिटर्मिनेशन विच वॉज दोज मीन्स वन वॉज एक्स एक्स एंड एक्स वाई टाइप ऑफ सेक्स डिटर्मिनेशन। सेकेंड इज एक्स 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 जीरो टाइप ऑफ सेक्स डिटर्मिनेशन एंड थर्ड इज जेड डब्ल्यू जेड जेड टाइप ऑफ सेक्स डिटर्मिनेशन। सो दे आर द थ्री टाइप्स इट वॉज प्रेजेंट अमॉन्ग दैट फर्स्ट टाइप एक्स एक्स एंड एक्स वाई टाइप ऑफ सेक्स डिटर्मिनेशन वी हैव बीन फिनिश्ड। सो एक्स एक्स एंड एक्स टाइप ऑफ सेक्स डिटर्मिनेशन वी विल फाइंड इन द मैमल्स ड्रोसोफिला इंक्लूडिंग इन अवर बॉडी ऑल्सो विल फाइंड द दिस टाइप ऑफ सेक्स डिटर्मिनेशन where XX is belongs to female. So we have both in a homogamete in condition, whereas the XY is nothing but heterogamete in condition, which will determine the male. So now today's class, let us discuss about the still two types of sex determination. So which are those means XX and X0 type, and third is ZW, ZZ type of sex determination. So we'll start by second type, that is nothing but XX and X0 type of sex determination. So this type of sex determination we will find in some insects and roundworms. In whose body we will find this type of sex determination? This type of sex determination we'll find in the insects and even in the roundworms. So let us discuss this type. So this type of sex determination we'll find in the insects, like which are the insects means grasshopper, bugs, etc. So and even in the roundworms also we will find. Roundworms means in ASCII helminthes. So in your first year you have been studied about the ASCII helminthes, so which commonly called as roundworms. In their body also we find this type of sex determination. So in this condition, here the females are XX chromosome. So here the female will be in which condition? Female will be in a XX in condition. So that's why the chromosomal complements, what it will come? The chromosomal complement is AA plus XX. AA is nothing but autosomes. What is the meaning of AA? AA means autosomes. As I said you here, in our body the chromosomes which is present, the chromosomes are divided into the two types. Yeah, one set we are calling it as autosomes, another set we are calling it as allosomes. So AA is nothing but autosomes, which will determines your somatic characters in your body, whereas allosomes which is present, it determines your sex of the organism. So AA is autosomes plus XX, so which is nothing but we are calling it as a female. So in this type of sex determination, so female, they are having the 2X say chromosomes, it will be present. So that's why they produce only one type of X. So both are same condition, both they are in the same pattern. So that's why we are calling it as a homogamete. So both are same, X both are XX in condition. So that's why what we are calling? We are calling it as a homogametic we are calling. So that's why they are producing only one type of X they are producing. And if you release the gametes for this one, means so gametes will be, what we will get here, A plus X will be the gamete. So A for autosome and X for XX are there. So one gamete will be released. Already we have been discussed in your previous class also. So if the two gametes, if both are in the same in condition, means we will release only one gamete will be released here. So both are in same condition. So that's why how many gamete will be released? One gamete. So that's why in female body we will find this type of pattern. So that's why how many types of eggs will produce, means they will produce only one type of egg will be produced in their body. So which contains autosomes and 1X chromosomes. What they contains? They contains autosomes. Which is the autosome? This is the autosome. They contains autosomes and 1X chromosomes they contains. Hence females, what we are calling? Females we are calling as a homogametic. What we are calling? Females we are calling as a homogametic condition we are calling. Whereas if you come to the males, if you come to males, means the males have only 1X chromosome. So males, what they having? No, they means they having only 1X chromosome it is present. Another one is the absent. So that's why we are indicating in the form of a zero. So that's why they produce just two types of sperm. So they are in a heterozygous in condition. This is different, this is different. So both are different. So that's why what we are telling it them as a heterogametic condition we are producing, we are telling, and they are producing the two types of sperms they are producing. Which are those two types of sperms? Means one we are calling it as a what here, autosomes and one X chromosome. One we are calling it as a autosome and one X chromosome. So that's why chromosomal complement will be A plus X we will get here. Whereas another what it is present, another with only autosomes and zero. So that is nothing but A plus zero. Hence the males are called heterogamete. So the males, what we are calling males, we are calling it as a heterogamete. So as males, they are producing the two types of sperms they are producing. Which are those two types of sperm? Is one is a plus X, another one is a plus a zero. So two types of sperms they are producing because they are in a heterogametic in condition. Whereas homogamete means females are producing only one type of X, that is nothing but, so we are calling it as a plus X. Even in our body also, female, we are having same pattern, it is present a plus XX. So that's why we are also releasing only one type of gamete. We are releasing egg will be only one type. Whereas if you come to the male, means male, they contains X and Y they present. So they are producing two types of gamete. So one contains A plus X, another it contains A plus Y it is present. But here Y is absent, so only one X it is present. So that's why one gamete we are calling it as A plus X and another gamete we are calling it as A plus zero it is present. So that's why male will be in heterogametic condition. So this is the female and this is the male. So what is this? This is the female it is indicating. What is this indicating? It is indicating the male. Male it is in a heterozygous condition, whereas female it is in a homozygous condition. Next here, during fertilization what happened? So gametes will fuse to each other. If X fuse with the sperm, so containing X chromosome develop into the female. So female egg always, as I said here, it's a female egg will be always A plus X only. Suppose here during fertilization, if this A plus X fused with the sperm having A plus X means, then what will be the offspring? The offspring will be what? It will develop into the what? The offspring will develop into the female. The offspring will develop into what? The offspring will develop into the female. So that's why during the fertilization, if egg fused with the sperm containing X chromosome. So what they're telling? X, suppose if it fused with the X chromosome. Which is the X chromosome? This is the X chromosome. If the cross is the sperm which contains the X chromosome, this sperm, if it fused with the egg, then what type of offspring will be born? The offspring will be born as a female. If suppose here, or else if the egg fused with the sperm without X, which is this is the without X, where the X is absent here. So if the sperm, if the egg fused with this type of sperm is, then the offspring will be as a male. So that's why the chromosomal complement what we'll get, A plus X zero it will come. Here the sex determination of the sex depends on what M is. It will depends on the what? The presence or absence of what M is? X chromosome. So that's why if what M is, if 2X of the offsprings are present means, then it will be the female. If 1X if it is present means, it will form as a male. So that's why who will determine the sex of an organism? Presence or absence of the X. How many X are present? 2X present means female. 1X present means male. In first case, who will determine the sex of an organism means? So presence or absence of the Y chromosome. If Y chromosome present means male. If Y chromosome absent means female. In the same manner, here who will determine the sex of an organism is, so how many X chromosomes are present? If 2X chromosomes are present means, if 2X chromosomes are present means, it will be the female. If 1X if it is present means, we are calling it as a male. So that's why the chromosomal complement illustration they have been given. So this is the female and this is the male. So female, they having what type of pattern? Chromosomal complement AA plus XX. AA means autosome. XX means this is the allosomes, this pattern they are having. Two X are present in the female body. Next, if you come to the male, so AA means autosomes, whereas X and 0 is nothing but, so this is the male, where another X is absent here. So that's why they are different in condition. We are calling it as a heterogamete, and this one we are calling it as a homogamete. We are calling, now we will release the gametes. So AA autosome plus diet, both are same in condition, homogamete in condition. So that's why we released only one gamete. So how many gamete will get? A plus X, this gamete will get. So that's why in the female body, how many types of egg will be produced? In the female body, only one type of egg it will be produced. Whereas if you come to the male, so male produces two different type of eggs it produces, because they are in a heterogamete in condition, they are present. So AM is autosome. Here though two different are present. So that's why we will release the two gametes. Even in your monohybrid cross also we have been discussed. So if they are in homozygous in condition means we will release only one gamete. If it is in heterozygous in condition means we will release the two gametes, capital T, small t. Here also same pattern we are following here. So I autosomes plus one X chromosome. Again autosome plus zero it is present. So that's why how many gametes will be released here? Two gametes will be released. Now fertilization. If the egg will fertilized with the, now what here, gamete which contains the X chromosome means, then what we'll get here? We'll get the female. So that's the X. So XX. So that what type of offspring we'll bought here? Born here? Female will get. Suppose the egg, if it fused with the gamete where the X chromosome is absent. So here X chromosome is absent. Then what type of offspring will be born here? Male offspring will be born. So A, then X, zero it is present. So that means here, so it will determine the male of an organism. So like that, so what it will mean is presence or absence, how many X chromosomes are present, it will determine the sex of an organism. So in this pattern, so we know the sex determination we will find in some insects and roundworms. In insects, in whose body means grasshoppers, bugs, in all these organisms we'll find this type of what sex determination we will find. So second type is finished. Next we'll go to the third type of sex determination. Two type is finished, third type of sex determination it is present. The third is ZW, ZZ type of sex determination it is present. So let us discuss about this one. So this type of sex determination was found in whose body we will find in the birds and reptiles. So this type of sex determination we will find in whose body we will find in the birds and the reptiles. So here female contains two different types of sex chromosomes and male having so same type of a chromosome. Here reverse, so female here they are in a which condition? In this case here female will be in a heterogametic in condition. So in this type here female will be in heterogametic in condition. So this ZW it is indicating the what? It is indicating the female. ZW it is indicating the female, whereas ZZ it is indicating the male. So in this case what happened is in this type of sex determination, so female what they contain here, female are in heterozygous in condition. So that's why how many types of egg it will be produced by the female means two different type of eggs will be produced by the female. So whereas in male how many types of sperm will be released means only one type of sperm will be released, because they are in a homogamete in condition, both are same but here they are different. So that's why two different type of eggs will be produced here, whereas here two different type of only one type of sperm it will be produced in this type here in birds and the reptiles. So this is the different pattern we will find in the sex determination. So let us discuss. Now the female produces two types of egg. Just now I said here the female it is in a heterozygous in condition. So female it will produces two types of eggs it is producing. So one type with the Z plus chromosome. So one type it is producing with the Z chromosome. That's why A plus Z. So A is a autosome and Z is one type of chromosome. Now another type of egg is a W. So A plus a W. So A for autosome and W for what here? Another type of chromosome. So that's why in this case the female, how many types of egg it will be produces? Female will produce as two different type of eggs will be produces. But we still know two types which we have been discussed. So in this case the female will produces only one type of egg it will produces, but male it will produces two different type of sperms it will produces. But this is the reverse. So ulta. So here the female it is producing two different type of eggs it is producing. So half of the eggs they having A plus Z pattern and half of the eggs it is having the A plus W type of a pattern. So that's why the female, it is in a heterogametic in condition. Whereas if you come to the males, male will be in a homogametic in condition. So that's why male, they having in a only one type of chromosomes are present. So that's why A plus Z where type of a sperm. So the sperms it is present are produced. All the sperms will be in a same pattern, it will be produced because they are in a homozygous in condition. Now during the fertilization, if the egg contains Z chromosome fused with the sperm Z, then what type of offspring will be developed here? Male offspring will be developed. So what they are telling here, during the fertilization, fertilization means you know very well, egg will fused with the what here? Male gamete. So this is the egg. Suppose if the egg they having A plus Z pattern, if it is means if the sperm and come and fuse with the sperm come and fuse A plus Z sperm and fuse come and fuse with this type of egg, means what type of offspring will get here, means AA plus ZZ. That is nothing but same word. What type of offspring will be born here? Male offspring will be born. Suppose here if the egg fused, if the egg which contains A plus W, if the egg it contains the A plus W pattern, it is present, and this type of egg it fused with the sperm male gamete A plus Z, means what type of offspring we will get here? The offspring will be the male offspring we will born here. That is nothing but AA ZW type we will get here. If egg containing W chromosome, if the egg containing what here? W chromosome A plus W fused with the sperm containing Z A plus Z, means so what we'll get here? We'll get the what here develops into the female offspring. So that means here AA ZW ZW. So what type of offspring we'll got here? Female, because here in they are in a heterogametic in condition. In female body we will find the heterogamete. So and determines the sex of an individual. So in this case like this, we'll get the sex of an individual we will get. So we will let us illustrate this one. So this is the female and this is the male. So here female, there is what is the chromosomal complement? AA means autosomes plus ZW. So this is the allosome. So here they are in a heterozygous in condition. Two different type of chromosomes are present. One is Z, another one is the W. This type of pattern we'll find in the female. Whereas if you come to the male, AA means autosomes. ZZ it is present. So both are same in condition. So that's why they are in a homogametic in condition. Homogametic in condition. So here they are heterogametic in condition. That's why they are producing the two different type of eggs they are producing. So in this case, female they are producing two different type of eggs they are producing. One egg they are having the A plus Z pattern, others egg they are having A plus W pattern it is present. Whereas male they releases only one type of gamete because they are in a homogametic in condition they are present. So that's why they will produce just only one type of gamete they will release here. Suppose here if the egg, this sperm it fused with the A plus Z egg, means what type of offspring will be born here? The male offspring will born here. AA ZZ. That means what type of offspring? Male offspring. Suppose here if the egg fused, if the sperm fuses with the egg which contains A plus W, means then what type of offspring will be born here? Female offspring we will born. WZ. AA plus WZ. Female type of offspring it will get born. So like the three different type of sex determination we will find in the organism. Next up. In our nature, another one type of organism they are present, their sex determination is completely different from this three different type of sex determination. So who is that? Means honeybee. So honeybee will not show this among the three types of sex determination. Honey, in honeybee sex determination is completely different. So this is one of the most important question for your exam, even for your what you need also, it is one of the important question related to the questions will be arises in your exam. So in later, even for your board exam also, it is one of the important question. So in the sex determination in honeybee it is different. So here sex determination it will be depends on who, means it will depends on fertilization and non-fertilization of the egg. So in this honeybee, how the sex determination it will take place, means in this case the sex determination it will take place by the fertilization and non-fertilization of the egg. So let us discuss about this one. Next, honeybee have a very different and unique type of sex determination. So compared, as I said you here, compared to other organism, so these honeybees, they shows a different type of sex determination. How it will shows different type? Let us see. So here sex is normally determined by the fertilization and non-fertilization of the egg, rather than the presence or absence of the sex chromosomes. So till now we've been discussed the presence or absence of the sex chromosomes. It will determine whether it is a male or whether it is a female. But in this case, honeybee, so presence or absence of the sex chromosome will not determine the sex. Then who is determining the fertilization and non-fertilization of the egg? It is determining the totemic sex of an individual. Let us see how this one. So this type of sex determination was first discovered by whom? Is Johann Dzierzon in 1845. So this type of sex determination, it was first discovered by whom? Is it was first discovered by a person called it as a Johann Dzierzon in 1845. In 1805, he is the person who discovered, who told about the sex determination in the honeybee. So male bee produces the sperm. So in honeybee, male bee, what it will produce as male it will produce as the sperm. Through how means? Through mitosis. Usually you know very well, the sperm or egg, it will be produced through which cell division? Means through meiosis cell division. So till now we know very well what it means. Gametes will be produced from whom? Means gametes will be produced through meiosis cell division. Whether it may be a male egg or it may be a what here? Sperm. If that may be a female or whether it may be a male. So both the gametes will be produced through which process? Through the meiosis process. But in this case, in the honeybee, the male is producing the sperm. Through which process? Means through the mitosis process. So that's why we are calling it as a unique, we are calling. So here the males, they are producing the sperm. Through which process? Means through the mitosis, not through the meiosis, keep remember. Whereas female produces the egg through meiosis. Whereas female, how they are producing? Female that produces the what here? Eggs through meiosis. Male will produce the sperm through mitosis. The eggs, the meiosis, the eggs without fertilization may develop into the haploid male called drones. So to whom we are calling it as a drones means the female will produce the eggs through meiosis, and that egg without fertilization directly it will develop into what here? It will develop into the haploid male. So directly what it is doing? It is developing into the haploid male. It is developing, and that male what we are calling means we are calling it as a drones. For male we are calling it as a drones. Male ko kya bolti hai? Male को drones बोलते हैं. How the male we will get here means males will we will get through without fertilization. So keep remember this one. How the male we will get means males we will get through without fertilization. Just now as I said you here. So in honeybee the sex determination it will be done with the due to the fertilization or non-fertilization. Here the female will produces the egg through meiosis. Female what it is doing? Female it is producing the egg through meiosis. But the eggs which has been produced, that eggs will not fertilized with the male without fertilization, not fertilized with the sperm. Sperm ke sath fertilize nahi hota. That means which process it is undergoing? It is undergoing the parthenogenesis. So parthenogenesis you have been studied in your first lesson. So you know very well. So parthenogenesis, through the parthenogenesis, it will not fused with the male. So directly the egg, it will develop into the haploid male, and that males what we are calling, we are calling it as a drone. And the eggs may be fertilized by stored sperms and develop into the diploid female of the sperm. Whereas some eggs, where are what are the female, how many the female it is producing the eggs, some eggs they are without fertilization, they'll develops into the egg. Suppose the female it has laid the 100 eggs, it has been laid. Female, how many eggs it has been laid? Female, it has laid the 100 eggs. Among that 100 eggs, 50 eggs without fertilization, directly it will develop into the male through the parthenogenesis process. Remaining 50 eggs, what it will do is it will fuse with the sperm. Remaining 50 eggs, what it will do? It will fuse with the sperm. So which and convert into the what here? Convert into the diploid female. So therefore, that's why the eggs may be fertilized by stored sperm. sperms will be in a stored condition. So remaining 50 eggs, what they'll do is they'll fertilize with the sperm and they'll convert into the diploid female. So whereas here male will be in a haploid condition, female will be in a diploid condition. So that's why we will get the female, in this pattern we'll get the female. Female will get it through the fertilization process and male we will get through the non-fertilization process. That is nothing but parthenogenesis we will get. So that's why in starting itself, as I said you here, so how the sex determination it will take place means sex determination it will take place through the fertilization and non-fertilization process. So through the fertilization process, what we'll get? We'll get the female we will get. And through the non-fertilization, what we'll get? Through the non-fertilization process, we'll get the male. So without fission, the males we will get. And males always they'll be in a haploid in condition. Whereas through the fission, so we'll get the female. Female will be in a diploid in condition. Female will be in a diploid in condition. And it requires, what you miss, if the require one female offspring is feed on the royal jelly and develops the queen, while other females are changed into the sterile workers. So 50 females are there. In that 50 females, all the females will convert into the sterile workers. So sterile means these females are unable to give birth to the young ones. So all they will convert into the sterile. Suppose if they need any queen, means among that female, one of the female will feed with the royal jelly. So one of the female, what will do? They will feed with the royal jelly and make them as a queen. And remaining 49, the female which will be present, they will undergo the sterile workers. So in this pattern, in the honeybee, the sex determination it will be taken place. So illustration I will show you here. See, this is the female. So that means here it is a queen. Only one queen will be present in the honeybee. So how many queens will be there? Only one queen will be there in the honeybee comb. So one female and it will one female. And this is the male. Now female, it is producing the egg. Female, what it is doing? It is laying the eggs. Female, what it is doing? It is laying the eggs. It is laying. So in through which process? Through the meiosis process. As I said you here, female will produce the eggs through meiosis. So female, what it is doing? It is producing the egg through meiosis process. And it has laid the meiosis. And you know very well, so through the meiosis means haploid will get. So in the female body, how many set of chromosomes are present? 32 chromosomes are present. In the female queen body, how many chromosomes are present? 32 chromosomes are present. Keep remember, so in a honeybee comb, so only one queen will be present. In her body, how many set of chromosomes are present? 32 set of chromosomes are present. This female, it will undergo the meiosis and produces the egg, which will be in a haploid. Meiosis means half set. 32 ka half kitna hota hai? 16. So it will produce the eggs. So which will be in a haploid in condition. X, it will be in a haploid in condition. Next, these eggs, few eggs, as I said here, how many eggs it will be produces? Among that, few eggs directly what they'll do is they'll undergo the parthenogenesis. That means they will not fused with the sperm. So half of the eggs what they will do, they will not fuse with the eggs. Directly they will go to the parthenogenesis. Parthenogenesis means you know very well. So without fission of the sperm, directly the egg will convert into the young ones. So through the parthenogenesis, egg directly it will convert into the offspring. So which is that offspring? The offspring will be the male. And that male we are given the name as a drone. So that male what we are calling? Male we are calling it as a drone. So which will be in which condition? It will be in a haploid in condition. Keep remember, it is important for your NEET and even for your board exam. So female it will be in a diploid in condition. Through the meiosis it will produce the egg. So that's why in the egg we will find how many types of gametes we will find. So how many types of chromosomes we will find? Haploid set of chromosomes are present. So that's why egg will be in a haploid. And without fertilization what happens is it is undergoing the parthenogenesis and producing the offspring. Now in the male body, how many set of chromosomes are present? Haploid set of chromosomes are present. So that's why male will be in a haploid set. So the males we are calling it as a drone. Whereas another case, so remaining the X which is present, that X will fused with the sperm. So which is the sperm? These are the sperm. And sperm will be released from the male body. As you know very well, sperm will released from the male body through mitosis process. So these are the males. So just now as I said here, male will be in haploid in condition. So that's why in male body 16 chromosomes are present. So the whatever the male we got, male it is in haploid. So this male it is producing the sperm. How the male it is producing the sperm is through the mitosis process. The X which is present, these X, half of the X, they will fused with the sperm and convert into the female. So the egg will be in haploid in condition, the sperm will be in a haploid in condition. So haploid, haploid fused means it will be in a diploid. So that's why female will be in a which condition? Female will be in a diploid in condition. So how many X female will be born? All the females will convert into the sterile workers. Females will convert into what? Females will convert into the sterile workers, because these females, they are unable to give birth to the young ones. These females are unable to lay the eggs. They will be present in the hive as a worker. They will be go on doing the work. Next, suppose if they need any queen, means among these ones, they will select any one queen, one female. The females which are present, so among them they will select only one female, and they will feed that female with a royal jelly and make them as a queen to lay the eggs. So in this pattern, they inside the honeybee, they are following. So this is the what any sex determination in the honeybee. So that's why, so as I said here, in honeybee sex determination, it will be done by the fertilization and non-fertilization. So through the non-fertilization, that means parthenogenesis, will get the male. So male we are calling as a drone, and through the what MS fertilization process, will get the female, and female will convert into the sterile worker. So like that, so completely what we'll get means, we'll get this sex, we'll get, keep remember, female it will be in diploid, male will be in a haploid in condition, and male we are calling as a drone, female will convert into the sterile worker. And if they need the what a queen means, the one of the female they will select among them, and they'll feed with the royal jelly and make them as a queen to lay the eggs. Remaining they will be in a worker by doing the work inside the hive. So this is the sex determination in different organism, where we finished. So next class we'll discuss our next topic, that is nothing but mutation.